I'm capping, guys. I'm capping. I don't want any smoke. I would not want to get hit with reports from a loving train. As you guys have seen from my last Epic 7 video that I pulled dizzy, surprisingly, without reaching the guarantee mark. And so far, oh baby, she's a bad omen. You guys know about her triple AoEs, and that strong attack 3 is nasty. That triple debuff was so important for my team since I do not have a second go-to healer to put into my team. So those debuffs substantially boosted my survivability. Raid bosses are so much easier for me to kill, and I went from being able to only auto Wyvern 7 to be now able to auto Wyvern 10 most of the time. Now for raid bosses, the fact that all three of her attacks are AoE, sometimes it's a little annoying because let's say for the very first raid boss, you don't want to trigger another damage phase, but then when it's Dizzy's turn, you have no choice but to use an AoE attack. And that might screw you over since you might need to heal or buff real quick and you don't really want to get hit. But you're kind of forced to kill off the adds. By the way, there's no mechanic in the game to skip a turn, right? I mean, if there is, then I'm just probably being dumb, but yeah, you're just forced to kill the adds. So that's a little bit annoying part. Now, I am stuck on Abyss level 62 because this little mechanic is just... it's like a anti-dizzy mechanic because the fact that I can't buff means that... or I can't debuff means that Dizzy's completely useless in this level, which kind of sucks because I was kind of steamrolling through the Abyss. I went through like 4 or 5 levels when I pulled her, and this decides to have this really, really awful mechanic. So more on Wyvern 10. Me autoing Wyvern 10 at this moment with this current squad is a kind of a hit or miss. Since only my Ken is faster than the Wyvern on its very first turn, and Ken is also the only one capable of taking 2 hits and living, that means that if the Wyvern is a troll and decides to hit either my Kisei or my Dizzy on its first turn, that means that I lose since one of them will die instantly with 2 taps, especially since the Wyvern won't have any debuffs on it. Since I need to rely on Dizzy being able to hit and apply the triple debuff as soon as possible on its very first turn. Now, this is my Dizzy set, which is a speed and hit set, so I can go fast and I can apply those debuffs. And of course, I have my substat rolls into a lot of effect resistance, you know, which is also beautiful. Like, that's exactly what I wanted. Not really. Now, I chose the Etika Scepter because that was the best mage artifact that I had, which is like an infinite debuff cycle because of so many cooldowns and the fact that I have a speed build on her. Now, I know the artifact that came with her would have been perfect and the most ideal, but since I pulled Dizzy first, the bookmark investment to pull the artifact is just not worth the investment, especially since there's no guarantee summons on her artifact. Now, if you guys want, here is a guide to building her from the Epic 7 wiki, which by the way is a fantastic website that I will just put to the link to in the description below. There's gonna be a Montmorency. I probably butchered that because I can't remember the exact name on top of my head. Specialty change coming up, but other than that, I'm very curious to see what's the next breakthrough content for this game. Because after the collab, it seems like unpredictable right now. I don't really know what they have planned for this game, but I'm very curious to see. So anyways, guys, that is it for today. And remember to...